Students, Sairam, this is Megha Miss here, and today we will be continuing with our lesson number 2, that is periodic classification of the elements. Okay, now the last presentation what we studied, I'll just do a quick recap. We studied about the merits of the Mendeleev's periodic table. You know, many of the scientists, they came forward, they started the classification of the elements. First was the Doppler, he made the triads, but that was not applicable for all the elements and hence it was not accepted, right? Second was again Newland, he started, he arranged them according to the law of octaves, right? But also he could not arrange all the elements, only till calcium it was done, and hence his classification was also not accepted, right? Then we saw Mendeleev, he came into the picture, he started arranging the elements, he gave his law that the properties of the elements are the periodic functions of their atomic masses, right? He said this, he gave this law, he started arranging the elements, he arranged in such a fashion that yes, all the elements got their position, even though the newly discovered elements also could get the place in that periodic table. He saw that this can also be done. Then we saw about the merits of Mendeleev's periodic table, that yes, he arranged the elements properly, he changed or revised, we can say, some of the atomic masses of the elements and tried to fit them properly in the periodic table. Then we saw he kept some vacant places for the newly discovered elements. Then we saw he made a zero group for the elements, okay, which was stable. Then we saw there were demerits also. He could not explain the position of the hydrogen atom in the periodic table. Then whatever the atomic masses were there, okay, whatever he arranged, the arrangement, it was not in proper sequence. Sequence means some elements which were newly discovered had the more atomic mass, he could not explain where to keep that, okay. So the arrangement regarding this increase in the atomic masses was not properly done. Then isotopes, he could not justify the position for the isotope in his table, okay. Like the demerits were also there, okay. Then we saw that even though it had demerits, some of the corrections were done, and yes, his table was used for the study, okay. And then came the modern periodic table, okay. Now in this modern periodic table, you saw the arrangement of the elements, that the elements are arranged properly in 4 blocks. You saw that also, S, P, D, F, right? So properly 118 elements were arranged in that. Also the isotopes got the place, okay. Then we saw according to the modern periodic law, it changed, it became the properties of the elements are the periodic function of their atomic numbers, right? The periodic law changed because of the modern periodic table what was introduced, okay students. So I hope till here what we have studied you have understood. Now the next we are going to study, that is the modern periodic table and the electronic configuration of the elements. Now you have studied this, how to write the electronic configuration of the elements, you have studied it before. Again we'll have a revision and how this electronic configuration is used for the arrangement of the elements in the modern periodic table, we will see that, okay. Now the elements in the same group show similarity and gradation in their properties. So whichever in the group, whichever elements are there, they are having different properties, okay. These characteristics of the groups and the periods in the modern periodic table are because of the electronic configuration of the elements. Means the electronic configuration is very important to decide the place of an element in a group and a period, okay. It is the electronic configuration of an element which decides the group and the period in which it is to be placed, as I told you now, okay. Now this is just an example. Now fluorine, you know, atomic number 9, you know, we write the electronic configuration as 2, 7. 2 electrons in the first orbit, 7 electrons in the second orbit. So here you can see fluorine between is the nucleus. I'll just show you. This is my nucleus. Okay, first orbit, this is my first orbit. Okay, it consists of the 2 electrons, you can see. Okay, this is my second orbit, it consists of the 7 electrons. Okay, can I say fluorine is stable now? No. How many electrons it will require to get stable? Yes, 1 electron, right? Because you know the capacity, electron capacity of the second shell is 8. Here 7 electrons are there. So fluorine can obtain 1 electron from some other atom and it can become a stable atom. Okay, we'll say that octet would get complete. I hope you understood how we write the electronic configuration. Okay, now one more example I'm giving you. Germanium, okay, 32. So how we'll write the electronic configuration? 2, 8, 18, 4. Okay, so here how many shells we are going to get? First one will be of 2 electrons, second shell will be for 8 electrons, third shell will have 18 electrons, and last shell will be of 4 electrons. Okay, in fluorine you saw that 7 electrons were there in the last orbit, means whatever the valence electrons are there, they are 7. Okay, here you can see the valence electrons, they are how many? 4. Okay, can you see this in the last orbit? You are going to have this remaining 4 electrons. So, I will say that valency of germanium is 4. Okay, I hope you have remember how we draw, how we write the electronic configuration and draw this electronic structures. Okay, these are very important for placing these elements in the periodic table. I hope you understood this. Okay, germanium we write it as Ge. Okay. Now, the next slide, groups and electronic configuration. Now, we will see, first we will take groups and we will see how it is helping for give the place to the elements depending upon their electronic configuration. Valence electrons in the elements from the group 1, that is the family of alkali metals, is the same. Okay, means whatever group 1 elements will be there, whatever their valence electrons will be there, they will be same. Okay, for example, the elements beryllium, magnesium, calcium belong to group 2, that is the family of alkaline earth metals. There are 2 electrons in their outermost shell. Okay, so all these electrons, they are in which group? Group 2. And when they are placed in the group 2, all of them have got 2 electrons in their outermost shell. Okay, students? Now, similarly, there are 7 electrons in the outermost shell of the elements such as fluorine. Now only in the last slide you have seen that it has got 7 electrons. Okay, and chlorine from the group 17, that is the family of halogens. So, if you see these 2 electrons, these 2 elements, fluorine and chlorine, you will get to see that they have got 7 electrons in their outermost shell. Okay. While going from top to bottom, within any group, 1 electronic shell gets added at a time. So, at a time, 1 electronic shell will get increased. Okay, students. From this, we can say that the electronic configuration of the outermost shell is the characteristic of a particular group. Yes, students, where it should be placed? If 2 electrons are there, it is placed in group 2. If 7 electrons are there, what is happening? They are placed together. Okay, the elements which are having 7 electrons in their outermost shell, they have been placed in group 17, okay, which is halogen family. So the electronic configuration of the outermost shell is a characteristic of a particular group. However, as we go down a group, the number of shells goes on increasing. If you go down a group, from up to down you come, then the number of shells goes on increasing. Here you can see with the help of this. Okay, this is a small periodic table. It is given in your text. From this only, I'll explain you how this points which we studied now are related with the periodic table. Okay, now what was the first point we studied? Now we saw beryllium, magnesium and calcium. Okay, it was said that they are in group 2 because they have 2 electrons in their outermost shell. Okay students, now can you see here, this is your beryllium, this is your magnesium and this is your calcium. Can you see 2, 2, 2? 2 electrons are there in their outermost shell. So where they are placed? They are placed in the group 2. Group 1, they are having 1 electron in their outermost shell. So can you see hydrogen? 1 electron. Lithium 1, sodium 1 and potassium 1. Can you see? 1, 1, 1 electron is there in their valence shell. So they are placed in the group 1. Okay, and again what we saw that we come from the up to down in a group, 1, 1 shell goes on increasing, right? Now here again if you see, I'll show you again, hydrogen you will have 1 shell, lithium it became 2 shell, sodium it became 3 shell, potassium it became 4 shell. Did you understand the point? Okay. So I hope how the groups are made and how the elements are arranged you have understood. Okay students, chlorine and fluorine, you can see it here, they have the 7 electrons in their outermost shell. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, now periods and electronic configuration, now we will see. Now we have seen about the groups. Okay, now we will see about the periods. While going from left to right within the period, the atomic number increases by 1 at a time. So when you go from left to right, what will happen? The atomic number increases by 1 at a time. Now you know hydrogen is 1, helium is 2, okay, lithium 3. So like this 1, 1 number, plus 1 is going on adding at a time, okay. And the number of valence electrons also increases by 1 at a time. Valence electrons will also increase 1 at a time. Hydrogen, 1 electron, right? Helium, 2 electrons. Lithium, 2 and plus 1 means 2 will be in first shell. 1 electron will be the valence electron, right? So like this, the 1, 1 valence electron will go on increasing. The elements with the same number of shells occupied by electron belonging to the same period. Okay, so the elements with the same number of shells occupied by the electrons belong to the same period. Okay, so first point you will remember, same number of shells, they will be having same number of shells in same period. Okay, now the elements in the second period, namely you have lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon, have the electrons in the 2 shells, okay, K and L. So their K and L shells will be there for all these elements. Okay, the elements in the third period, namely that is sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine and argon, have electrons in the 3 shells, K, L, M. Okay, so here you can see that second period, 2 shells, important. Then third period, 3 shells, important. Okay students, did you understand this? Second period means 2 shells, third period, 3 shells, fourth period, 4 shells and so on. Okay, now in the modern periodic table, electrons are filled in the same shell while going a long period from left to right. And at the beginning of the next period, a new electron shell starts filling up. So when you go along from left to right, you if you see, the electrons which are added up will be in the same shell. But when you come down to the next, from third you come to fourth, then a new electron shell starts filling up. Okay students, we will see it. Okay, again same diagram I am using to explain you about the periods. Now what we saw about the periods, we saw that one electron goes on adding and one valence electron is going on adding. Okay, so see here, as I gave you example, hydrogen 1, helium will become 2, lithium will become 3, beryllium 4. So like this, 1 number is going on increasing. Okay, then what we saw, that when you go along a period from left to right, okay, so when I'm going from left to right, you will see that the one whatever the electron is increasing, it is getting inside the same shell. Okay, two shells will be only there. See, can you see lithium here? Lithium, you have two shells. Okay, first shell 2 electrons, second shell 1 electron. Beryllium, first shell 2 electrons, second 2. Boron 2, 3. Carbon 2, 4. Okay, so on. Can you see? Yes. But after neon, if you see, neon is 2, 8, stable atom, right? When it comes to the group when it comes to the period, next period, that is the third period, you will see that 2, 8, 1 means one more period, one more electronic shell has been added up. That is 2, 8, 1, 2, 8, 2, 2, 8, 3, 2, 8, 4. So three shells are there, right? For the different elements. This is explained in this modern periodic table. Okay, students, did you understand this arrangement? Again, you can see here argon structure is shown. 2, 8, 8. Can you see this argon atom? Yes. How many shells were there? 3. It belonged to period 3. Now, potassium, you can see here, it is belonging to period 4. How many shells it is having? 4 shells. Okay, students, did you understand this concept? Okay, now, as per the electron holding capacity of these shells, 2 elements are present in the first period and 8 elements in the second period. Okay, so as per the electron holding capacity of the shells, only 2 elements are there in the first period, that is hydrogen and helium, and 8 electrons in the second period. Okay, the third period also contains only 8 elements due to the law of electron octet. Okay, due to the law of electron octet, as the electron holding capacity of the shells, 2 elements are present in the first period, 8 elements in the second, and third period also contains only 8 elements due to the law of electron octet. Okay, students, now this is the shell. N is the number of shells. 2N square we are doing. Okay, this is the formula, 2N square, to find the electron capacity. Okay, students, now here you can see, first shell is the K shell, N will be 1. So 2 into 1 square will be 2. So first shell will be containing 2 electrons. Second is L, it is the second one. So 2 into 2 square, it will become 8. M is the third, 2 into 3 square, it will become 18. N, fourth one, 2 into 4 square, it is 16 into 2, it will become 32. Okay, student, so this is the electron capacity of the different shells. K shell, remember, 2 electrons. L, 8. M, 18. N, 32. Right, like this, if you go on calculating using the formula 2N square, you can easily find how much electrons you have to show in the next shell. Okay, students, did you understand what is the formula to find the electron capacity? 2N square. Okay, N is the number of the electronic shells. So electronic shell number 1, electronic shell number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Depending upon the atomic number, that much electron shells you have to draw, and then you will put up the electrons. Okay, students, I hope you understood till here. Okay, now, the chemical reactivity of any element is determined by the number of valence electrons in it. So the chemical reactivity of any element is determined by the number of valence electrons in it and the shell number of the valence shell. Okay, students, so how many valence electrons are there? That is important for the chemical reactivity of that element. The information on this points is obtained from the position of that element in the periodic table. From the periodic table, can you tell how many valence electrons it has? Yes, because with the help of atomic number, you can draw up the electronic configuration. When you write the electronic configuration, you will understand the last shell will have how many electrons. And if it has got less electrons, more electrons, you can tell that. Okay, that is, the modern periodic table has proved useful for the study of the elements. So this modern periodic table has been proved to be very useful for the study of the elements. I hope you understood this. Okay, so today we studied about, we have come to the end of the presentation. We studied about what you studied first, modern periodic table and the electronic configuration. We saw some of the elements and how we write the electronic configuration. You have studied this in your previous standard also, if you remember. Okay, so the modern periodic table is based, the arrangement of the elements is based on this electronic configuration. Okay, students, we saw the groups and the electronic configuration, that how the arrangement of the elements in a particular group is done because of this electronic configuration. Okay, then we saw the periods and the electronic configuration. Okay, that how the whatever the periods, whatever the elements are arranged in the particular period, how it is due to the electronic configuration. Okay, we studied about that. Also in that we studied about the electron capacity of the different shells using the formula 2n², right? Very important. Number of electrons which are present in the last orbit, okay, which we call them as valence electrons. They are very important for the chemical reactivity of the elements, okay. How many valence electrons are there, that can be determined with the help of this electronic configuration only. And thus, the modern periodic table proved very useful for the study of the elements and their chemical reactivity. Okay, students, I hope what we did today you have understood. Okay, so I'll stop it today here. I hope you are studying properly the presentations, you're going through them, solving the assignments what is given down in the link. Okay, try to solve those properly and keep practicing the answers also. Okay, so thank you, Saira.